So let's discuss about rate control versus rhythm control in atrial fibrillation. Okay, so this is a recent update. So regarding rhythm control for high risk early atrial fibrillation for patients with newly diagnosed atrial fibrillation who are at high risk for cardiovascular complications, and especially if the patient is symptomatic. Okay. So we are at high risk for cardiovascular complications, and especially if the patient is symptomatic, we suggest rhythm control. Okay, we suggest rhythm control rather than rate control, provided it can be initiated within 12 month of onset. Okay, so we prefer rhythm control versus rate control. So this is about the trial. Okay, among patients with early atrial fibrillation, a survival benefit for from rhythm control rather than rate control strategy has never been demonstrated. So survival benefit from rhythm control rather than rate control has never been demonstrated. The East AFNET 4 trial randomly assigned nearly 2,800 patients with early atrial fibrillation. Early means defined as diagnosed less than 12 months before enrollment and at high risk for cardiovascular complications to early rhythm control with antiarrhythmic drugs or catheter ablation, or to usual care, which was rate control strategy for most patients. Okay, so it was a rate control versus rhythm control was tested here. So rhythm control versus let me choose again. Okay. Rhythm control versus rate control in this trial. Okay, our East AFNET 4 trial randomly assigned nearly 2,800 patients with early AF defined as diagnosed less than 12 months before enrollment at high risk for cardiovascular complications. So it's also note here, high risk, these are for high risk for cardiovascular complications to rhythm control with antiarrhythmic or catheter ablation, or to usual care, which was rate control strategies. Okay, and high risk was defined as age greater than 75 years, prior transient ischemic attack and stroke, or meeting two of the following criteria, that is age greater than 65 years, female sex, heart failure, hypertension, diabetes, severe coronary artery disease, chronic kidney disease, or left ventricular hypertrophy. So this is the definition of high risk. Okay, so you also have to take care of this in mind. High risk was defined as age greater than 70 years, prior transient ischemic attacks or a stroke, or meeting two of the following five criteria: age greater than 65 years, okay, female sex, heart failure, hypertension, diabetes, severe coronary artery disease, okay, just not coronary artery disease, severe coronary artery disease, okay, and chronic kidney disease or left ventricular hypertrophy. After a median follow-up of 5.1 years, so they were followed for 5.1 years, the group assigned to rhythm control had a lower rate of death from cardiovascular disease, 1 versus 1.3%, and a stroke. It was also lower, 0.6 versus 0.9% compared to the group assigned to rate control. Okay, so based on these results, we now prefer early initiation of the rhythm control strategy for most AF patients meeting the criteria for high risk. So if early AF and plus high risk, in those patients we prefer rhythm control rather than rate control. Okay, previously we preferred rate control for many of these patients, particularly if they are older and minimally symptomatic. Okay, but now we prefer rhythm control if early AF and this high risk criteria is meeting, this that we discussed. So we prefer rate control in these patients. Okay, so that's all about it.